He's the man who had us all saying hi to our mums for him. Rove McManus is a gifted comedian, presenter and producer. His Rove Prizes company is responsible for some of Aussie TV's most loved shows.
Yeah, after going from Gold Logie winner to Jay Leno regular, Rove's made the move stateside and he's got a brand new baby that's hot off the satellite.
He's the comedian with the funny name.
With someone who has anus in their surname, I'm very careful in more ways than you know.
The gift of the gab.
Well, strap yourself in, Inspector. It's going to be a wild ride.
And a knack for getting other people talking.
And all of a sudden, these bunnies came out of nowhere and they started to go like this. And I said, I think that means in Russian.
But showbiz is no laughing matter for Rove McManus, popping on his executive producer's cap to create some of the most popular shows on Australian TV, from his self-titled talk show...
Thank you very much. I'm Rove McManus. Say bye to your mum for me.
..to comedy sketches, public affairs programs, and even hard-hitting news.
It's getting better and better, this story.
Last year, he packed up to say g'day to the USA.
It's a very interesting indicator that the audience was less repulsed by the fact you've got a screwdriver in your nose and more repulsed by the fact you licked it afterwards.
Now he's settled in Tinseltown, entertaining the Yanks with his Aussie humour.
North Australia!
And setting tongues wagging once again with a brand new Los Angeles-based chat show, Rove LA.
Let's go chat to these guys. They're not going to interview themselves.
Well, that funny little man himself joins us now all the way from L.A., Rove. Hello.
I thought maybe I'd passed away and you were putting together my memorial packet.
Yes. How would you like to be remembered? That's the next question. Mate, how's it treat? Thanks for dressing up, firstly.
Taller than you.
Yeah, you're all right. How's L.A. treating you, mate?
It's going very well, thank you for asking. It's a lovely day outside, as you can tell by my wonderful backdrop.
As an Aussie comedian in the States, do the Yanks get your sense of humour, Rove? Do they get you?
The sense of humour as a whole they get, like, funny is funny, but it's little turns of phrase and things like that that they don't quite understand. Like, you know, I've mentioned, you know, the phrase, up myself on stage. They don't know what that means. They think, you know, you're a great contortionist. If you use the term like, you know, chuck it in the boot, they think you're going to throw up in their shoes. So once you get past that hurdle, you're okay.
But you've done some great stuff over there. And we get snippets every now and again back here. The Chelsea Lately show, the Jay Leno show. What's it like, you know, hanging out with those guys?
It's good. It's really interesting to see how people like that put their show together, considering, especially for me, to be doing something for the Tonight Show. Even for the show we used to do and still do now, it's once a week, but people refer to it as being a Tonight Show. It's the brand that this show started. So to get to be part of that is a huge thrill.
Rove, people might look at you and go, look, that Rove, he's so lucky, he's just a funny guy and he's just sort of making it over there. But you've worked really hard to achieve this. Just tell us how long that road has been.
Since I was born.
You work really hard.
Well, I do. I've had it pretty easy the last sort of 12 months or so. I've just sort of been having a bit of time off, which has been... really good fun. It's been nice to sort of be sitting by a pool and going, what day is it again? But prior to that, yeah, it's even now, even though the show is only once a week, I'm in the office every day. Right now, it's a Sunday afternoon, and here I am talking to you guys because the people have spoken, Larry and Kylie. I had to do your show.
Well, yes, the Facebook poll said that you had to come on the morning show today.
Yeah, and Larry wouldn't stop tweeting you. Like, that's almost like harassment, isn't
it,
right?
It's stalking. It's stalking, right?
It is. It's cyber stalking, and I'm glad I can still do it from this side of the world without having to just spy outside his window anymore.
Mate, are there pinch yourself moments over there? There must be now. I remember meeting you Channel 31 back in the day, and I think the budget for that show was $50 a week or something like that. And look at you now with the big thing
over
there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
It is exciting. It's been a long road to get here, and I never thought that I would get to do more than just what I was doing in Australia, and that was so fulfilling to get to do that. And to walk away from it at the end of 10 years was a very scary move, but it felt like it was the right thing to do at the time. And to feel like now is maybe the start of that next phase of my career is very exciting.
So tell us about the show, Rove. It kicked off last week. We're seeing Lisa Kudrow, Kathy Griffin and Turtle from Entourage. Tell us about the show.
Well, essentially, the idea is it's the next step from where the show used to end up. So we would finish with everybody who was part of the show would be on the couch and we'd just kind of have an all-in conversation. Well, now the plan is that that's the start of the show. And it's worked out pretty good so far. I think everyone's blending really well. It's like being at like a dinner party or cocktail party. And I think for the first time ever on a show like this, the guests are even there right from the top when I'm telling my jokes, which could prove to have me have some of the most famous hecklers I've ever seen in my entire life.
So working on the show over there, Rove, have you surrounded yourselves by Aussies or are you working with Americans on your show over there?
It's a bit of a split between both. So yeah, we do have mainly, especially for writers and things like that, we need Australians because that's who we're talking to. But there are obviously, being in the States, a lot of Americans here too. And I think they haven't quite worked this out yet, but they'll get there eventually. Mate, they will learn.
You'll straighten them out.
This is what's happening. We all know you in Australia. The people you're inviting onto the couch over there mightn't know you necessarily. So, of course, they're going to head to the internet and they're going to head to websites that are going to tell them that you're a keen kangaroo breeder. And in fact, you own one of the largest kangaroo farms in Australia. You need to tidy this stuff up, Rove.
Well, I think also on there is that I'm your son's godfather as well.
Yeah. Are you not?
I think I put that on there. Yeah. That's the problem.
Yes, that's right.
But yeah, there's... Well, the thing is, it says that I'm a keen kangaroo breeder, which is possible. I'm a bit of a nature nut, but the fact it says I'm the only owner of the rare blue-tailed kangaroo is a big giveaway because no such animal exists.
Yeah, we might add to that today. I've got some good ideas for your site there.
Do you get a little bit homesick?
Yes, if anyone would like to add to my false information, feel free.
Yeah.
Do you get homesick at all, Rove? I mean, like tonight in Melbourne, the Brownlow's on, footy grand final. You know?
Yes, and Ricky Nixon's at it again.
Yeah, yeah.
So, well, I've kind of, especially as a bit of an AFL fan, we've had a split in the house between my wife Tasma and I because she's a big West Coast supporter and I'm a Fremantle supporter. So she's been she was a little bit upset that the Eagles got quite soundly beaten over the weekend, and I can't help but not really care too much because we've never even seen the likes of a grand final, so my heart doesn't go out to her that much.
All right, and mate, we're glad that the poll suggested that you had to do this program today. Great to catch up. Continued success, and we look forward to hearing more about it. We'll be watching tonight, right?
See you guys soon, I hope.
Okay. Yeah, I think Hugh Jackman on the show tonight. You can catch Rove LA on Mondays at 8:30 p.m. on Foxtel's Fox 8. He's doing great.
Good stuff. Thanks, mate. Still